طيب، بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسوله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، we begin today inshallah the 18th sitting, مجلس الثامن عشر في غزوة البدر. So في in on the talking about the Badr, the war of Badr. So begin here, بسم الله. So the Sheikh begins with his introduction. الحمد لله القوي المتين القاهر الظاهر المالك الحق المبين لا يخفى على سمعه خفي الأنين ولا يعزب عن بصره حركات الجنين ذل لكبريائه جبابرة السلاطين السلاطين وقضى القضاء بحكمته وهو أحكم الحاكمين أحمده حمدا حمد الشاكرين وأسأله معونة الصابرين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له لا شريك له إله الأولين والآخرين أشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله المصطفى على جميع المرسلين المنصور ببدر بالملائكة المنزلين صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إحسان إلى يوم الدين وسلم تسليما. So the Sheikh Bismillah, he begins with the introduction. He mentions all praise belongs to Allah, the strong, the omnipotent, the most high, the true king. He the one who hears the whimpering of the whimperer and is not hidden from him and his from his hearing, so he can hear the whimpering of the whimperer and the movement, and he sees the movement of the fetus in the belly of his mother, the tyrannical leaders humble themselves to his glory. He is the one who decreed the destiny based upon his wisdom, and he is the most wise. I praise him with the praise of the thankful, and I ask him the support of the forbearing ones. And I bear witness that none has the right to be worshipped in truth except Allah alone. And I bear witness that Muhammad is his slave and his messenger, the one who is given preference over all the messengers, the one who was aided on the day of Badr with the descending angels. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower his blessings and favor on his family members, his companions, on him and those who follow the footsteps till the day of judgment. So then the Shaykh he begins, he says, Ikhwani, my brothers again, في هذا الشهر المبارك نصر الله المسلمين في غزوة بدر الكبرى على أعدائهم المشركين وسمى ذلك اليوم يوم الفرقان. So the Shaykh begins, he says, my brothers, in this month, this blessed month, Allah aided the give victory to the Muslims in the Battle of Badr. And that Battle of Badr, some of the scholars mentioned, it took place on the 17th of Ramadan, which was according to the 17th will be yesterday. Yeah, will be the 17th that we have. So that was over 1400 years ago that happened. And that battle happened in Ramadan, subhanAllah, as did so many other battles that took place in the blessed month of Ramadan. So they were victorious over their enemies, the disbelievers, the polytheists of Mecca. And Allah, and it was called the day of criterion, or distinguishing, the day of distinguishing, because لأنه سبحانه فرق فيه بين الحق والباطل وبنصر رسوله والمؤمنين وخذل الكفار المشركين. So that day, it was named the day of distinguishing or criterion, because in that day, Allah the Most High, He distinguished between the truth and falsehood, the truth which the Muslims were upon and the falsehood the disbelievers, the polytheists were upon, by giving victory to His Messenger and the believers, and by forsaking and abandoning the disbelievers, the polytheism. So كان ذلك في شهر رمضان من سنة الثانية من الهجرة. So that was in the month of Ramadan in the second year after Hijrah, when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and the Muslims migrated to Medina. It was the second year after that. وكان سبب هذه الغزوة أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغه أن أبا سفيان قد توجه من الشام إلى مكة بعير قريش فدعا أصحابه إلى خروج إليه لأخذ العير لأن قريش حرب لرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وأصحابه ليس بينه وبينهم أحد وقد أخرجوهم من ديارهم وأموالهم وقاموا ضد دعوتهم دعوة الحق فكانوا مستحقين لما أراد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وأصحابه بإيرهم. So we stop there. So the Sheikh, he mentions here, and this, the reason for this war was that the Prophet ﷺ came to know that the Abu Sufyan. So Abu Sufyan was one of the leaders of Quraysh. He later would become Muslim, but at this time, he was from the disbelievers and from the leaders of the disbelievers. That he was heading from Syria. So the Arabs used to trade in Syria a lot, and they would trade in Yemen a lot. So these they would take turns, whether it was summer or winter, they would switch over, alternate where they would trade. So Syria, they would make a lot of trade, and he was on his way back to Mecca with the caravan of the Quraysh. So with all their possessions and all their wealth. So the Prophet called his companions to go out to take this caravan from Abu Sufyan. Why? Because the Quraysh were having a war. There was no pact of peace between them. Yeah, between them and the Prophet, the Messenger of Allah and his companions. So there was no peace treaty between them. And they indeed took them out of their houses in Mecca. And the dwelling places, and they took their wealth. They took their wealth from them. They kicked them out of their house in Mecca, and they took all their wealth from them. And they stood in opposition to the dawah of truth, which is the call to Tawheed and the dawah of Islam. And they were so they were deserving of what the Prophet ﷺ and his companions were intending in regards to taking their caravan. So then the Sheikh mentions, فَخَرَجَ النَّبِي صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ وَأَصْحَابَهُ فِي 312 رَجُلٌ عَلَى فَرْسَيْنِ وَسَبْعِينَ بَعِيرًا يَتَأَقَّبُونَهَا مِنْهُمْ 70 رَجُلًا مِنَ الْمُحَاجِرِينَ وَالْبَاقُونَ مِنَ الْأَنْصَارِ يَقْصُدُونَ الْإِيرَ لَا يُرِيدُونَ الْحَرْبَ. So here, we just translate that way and then we'll continue. So the Sheikh, he mentions that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companions, they went out and there was 300 and between 313 and 319. So it was not even 320 of them, including the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who went out and they had two horses only and they had 70 camels. And there they would take turns on riding these riding beasts, where 70 of the men were from the Muhajirin, were those who emigrated from Mecca. So they were the Muslims, the original Muslims who emigrated from Mecca. There were 70 of them. And the remaining of them, you can do the maths, between 313 and 319, the remaining of those, apart from the 70, were all from the Ansar, meaning the ones who aided the Muslims, who were the Muslims in Medina. So and they intended the caravan, and they didn't want to have a war. Then the Sheikh said, وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ جَمَعَ بَيْنَهُمْ وَبَيْنَ أَدُوِّهِمْ عَلَى غَيْرِ مِعَادِ لِيَقْضِيَ اللَّهُ أَمْرًا كَانَ مَفْعُولًا وَيَتِمَّ مَا أَرَادَ فَإِنْ. So here, they went out intending the caravan, yeah, but Allah decreed for them to meet the enemies without a prior appointment. That was from the decree of Allah for that battle to take place. So from the intent and the will of Allah. And then فَإِنَّ أَبَا سُفْيَانَ عَلِمَ بِهِمْ فَبَعَثَ صَارِخًا إِلَى قُرَيْشٍ يَسْتَنْجِدُوهُمْ لِيَحْمُوا إِيرَهُمْ وَتَرَكَ طَرِيقَ الْمُؤْتَادَةَ وَسَلَكَ سَاحِلَ الْبَحْرِ فَنَجَى. So Abu Sufyan, he came to know that the Muslims are coming to take the caravan. So what happened? He sent a person, someone who's a messenger who went out screaming to the Quraysh that they should come and aid them, yeah, and that they should come and protect their caravan. So what did Abu Sufyan do? His normal path, which would have been a direct path from Syria to Mecca, what he did, he took a different path. He diverted from his usual route, and he went towards the where the coast near the sea, and then he escaped the Muslims. سأما قريش فإنهم لما جاءهم الصارخ خرجوا بأشرافهم أن بقرة أبيهم في نحو ألف رجل معهم مئة فرس وسبعمائة بعير. So then the Sheikh mentions, as for the Quraysh, the tribe, when the person who came, you know, screaming out, the messenger saying that the Muslims are going to attack Abu Sufyan and take the caravan, they all came out. The noble ones of them, all of them came out. And there was approximately 1,000 of them. So 313 or 319, you know, 320, just say, compared to 1,000 of these Quraysh. Yeah. So, and they had with them 100 horses, while the Muslims had 2. And they had 700 camels. How many did the Muslims have? 70. Shows you the difference in numbers. So then Allah mentions, بَطَرًا وَرِئَاءَ النَّاسِ وَيَصُدُّونَ عَن سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ بِمَا يَعْمَلُونَ مُحِيطٌ. So this is Surah Al-Anfal. And it's ayah number 74. Here we go. So here we say, so he said, and they came out of their homes boastfully and to be seen of men and hinder men from the path of Allah. Yeah, so this was path of Allah, and Allah is encircling and thoroughly comprehending all that they do. So they came out showing off to the rest of the tribes of Arabia so that they could see that they're going to go and fight, and they thought it would be an easy thing to defeat the Muslims. وَمَعَهُمْ الْقِيَانُ يُغَنِّينَ بِهِجَاءِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. So with them there was women who were singing, who were attacking the Muslims, you know, slandering them, whether with poetry and songs. فَلَمَّا عَلِمَ أَبُو سُفْيَانَ بِخُرُوجِهِمْ بَعَثَ عَلَيْهِمْ يُخْبِرُهُمْ بِنَجَاتِهِ وَيُشِيرُ عَلَيْهِمْ بِرُجُوءٍ وَعَدَمَ الْحَرْبِ. So when Abu Sufyan knew, he came to know that the Quraysh had come out, yeah, and that they going out to battle. So he sent to them a messenger telling them that, yeah, no, I'm successful. You know, the Muslims didn't catch me, yeah. So he directed them to return and don't go into battle. فَأَبُوا ذَلِكَ وَقَالَ فَأَبَوْا ذَلِكَ وَقَالَ أَبُو جَهْلٍ وَاللَّهِ لَا نَرْجِعُ حَتَّى نَبْلُغَ بَدْرًا وَنُقِيمُ فِيهِ ثَلَاثًا وَنَنْحَرُ جُزُورًا وَنُطْعِمُ الطَّعَامَ وَنَسْقِي الْخَمْرَ وَتَسْمَعُ بِنَا الْعَرَبُ فَلَا يَزَالُونَ يُحَابُونَنَا أَبَدًا. So they So they rejected that. Yeah. So they rejected the command of Abu Sufyan. So Abu Jahl. Yeah. He said. So they rejected, and Abu Jahl, one of the major enemies of Messenger of Allah, said, "By Allah." So he shows that they swore by Allah, they worshipped Allah. He said, "By Allah, we will not return until we reach Badr, and we stay there for 3 days, and we will sacrifice our camels, yeah, for and we will feed." And we eat upon the, they would eat there, and they would drink wine, and they then until the Arab would hear about us, the rest of the tribes of the Arab, and they would increase, and it would increase them in the fear. You know, they would continue to fear us. So this is they wanted to show, make a show, and show on board about this whole affair. They thought they're going to win, so they wanted to go out. And show that they were strong, and they wanted to show the other Arabs so that they continue to fear them. So then the Sheikh says, "Amma Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, fa innahu lamma alima bi khuruj Quraysh jama min man ma'ahu min as-sahabati fa istasharahum wa qala inna Allah qad wa'adani ihda at-ta'ifatayn imma al-'ira aw al-jaysha." فقام المقداد بن مقداد بن الأسود وكان من المهاجرين وقال يا رسول الله إني لما أمرك الله عز وجل فوالله لا نقول كما قالت بنو إسرائيل لموسى فاذهب أنت وربك فقاتلا إنا هاهنا قائدون. Stop there, yeah. So then, as for the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he came to know of the Quraysh coming out to battle, he gathered the companions that were with him, and he sought to seek their opinion, their views. And he said to them, "Indeed, Allah has promised me one of the two, either the caravan or the the army, meaning the victory." In defeating the army. So one of the companions, Miqdad ibn al-Aswadi, Miqdad ibn al-Aswad, he was from the Muhajirin, those who were from Mecca, the Muslims from Mecca. So he said, "O Messenger of Allah, carry out what Allah has commanded you with, and by Allah, we will not say like the children of Israel, Bani Israel," said to Musa. I mean, just get the translation of that, which is, they said, "Oh Musa," they said, "we will never enter as long as they are there. So go you and your Lord and fight you too. We are sitting right here." Subhanallah. So they're saying that, yeah, we're not going to be like those ungrateful people. We're going to go out and we're going to fight in the path of Allah. ولكن نقاتل عن يمينك وعن شمالك وعن بين يديك ومن خلفك وقام. So then he said, rather we're gonna fight in front by your right, by on your left, from in front of you and from behind you. So you know the so that was from the Muhajir. As for the وقام سعد بن معاذ الأنصاري سيد الأوس فقال يا رسول الله لعلك تخشى أن تكون الأنصار ترى حقا عليها أن لا تنصرك إلا في ديارهم وإني أقول أن الأنصار عن الأنصار وأجيب عنهم فضعا حيث شئت وصل حبل من شئت وقت حبل من شئت وخذ من أموالنا ما شئت وأعطنا منها ما شئت وما أخذت منا كان أحب إلينا مما تركت وما أمرت فيه من أمر فأمرنا فيه تبع لأمرك فوالله لئن صرت بنا حتى تبلغ البركة من غمدان لا نسيرن معك، ولئن استعرت بنا هذا البحر فخدته لنخوضنه معك، وما نكره أن تكون تلقى أدوى 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 بنا غدا. إننا لصبر عند الحرب، صدق عند اللقاء، ولعل الله يريك منا ما تقر به عينك. So we'll stop there and we'll continue. So then Sa'd ibn Mu'adh from the Ansar. So before was the Muhajir from Mecca, and now the Muslim from Mecca, and now one of the Muslims from companions from Ansar, and he was the leader of the Aus, the tribe. And he said, O Messenger of Allah, you fear the Ansar, meaning the Muslims from Medina. They only see that they have a right, that you have a right upon them to aid you in their residence, meaning in Medina. But I say, and I speak on behalf of the Ansar, that do you know, go and do as you please, and you connect with who you please, you know, in terms of treaties, and break whatever treaty you please, and take from our wealth whatever you please, whatever pleases you, and give us from it whatever pleases you, and that you take from our wealth is more beloved to us if then you leave it, and whatever you command, we will do. Yeah, we follow that command. By Allah, if you were to go travel with us and reach the pool of Ghamdan, which is in Yemen, further down is Yemen, we would go with you, we follow you. And if you were to go into, if you command us to go with us to the sea and plunge into the sea, we would plunge into the sea with you. Dive into the sea with you, and we do not hear to meet the enemy tomorrow. Yeah, so we do not hear to see the enemy. Indeed, we are patient with war. So they are patient with war, and we are truthful in the meeting. So we are truthful. They're not going to be treacherous and run away, and then. We hope that Allah shows you that from us that which would please your eyes. So then, فَسُرَّ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ لِمَا سَمِعَ مِنَ الْكَلَامِ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَالْأَنْصَارِ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَقَالَ سِيرُوا وَأَبْشِرُوا فَوَاللَّهِ لَكَأَنِّي أَنْظُرُ إِلَى مُصَارِ الْقَوْمِ. So the Prophet ﷺ, he was pleased with this, what he heard from the Ansar, and what he heard from the Muhajirin, from the group, both the groups of the Muslims. He was pleased. May Allah be pleased with them. So Allah, so the Messenger ﷺ said, he said, go and see. He said, go ahead and be happy by Allah. I see the place of the places where the enemies will die. So he can see the places where they will die, or the resting places of the yeah. So then, the Sheikh he said, "Fasara Nabi." صلى الله عليه وسلم بجنوده الرحمن حتى نزلوا أدنى ماء من مياه بدر فقال له الحباب بن المنذر بن عمرو بن جموح يا رسول الله أرأيت هذا هذا المنزل منزل أنزلكه الله، ليس لنا أن نتكدم عنه أو نتأخر، أم هو رأي والحرب والمكيدة؟ فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: بل هو رأي والحرب والمكيدة. فقال: يا رسول الله، إن هذا ليس بمنزل، فانحد بنا حتى نأتي أدنى ماء من القوم فننزله ونغور ما وراءه من القلب، ثم نبني عليه حوضا فنملأه فنشرب ولا يشربون. فاستحسن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم هذا الرأي ونحد. So you stop there. So here the Sheikh mentions that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he first said, get ready for the fight and rejoice, but Allah is as if I see the dying spots of the enemies. So then the Prophet ﷺ proceeded with the companions until they reached one of the rivers of Badr. Yeah. So then he stopped there. So then one of the companions, and his name was Habab ibn Munzir, the son of Amr bin al-Jamu, he asked, O Messenger of Allah, this place, is it basically from revelation from Allah? And that obviously we do not contend with that. Is it something that is revealed to you but from Allah, or is it from the strategy of war and opinion? Yeah. So, the Prophet said, rather it is from the from my opinion and from the strategy of war. So then he said, O Messenger of Allah, this place is not a suitable place. So get up from here and come with us so that we go further down into the we go down so that the so we cross the other side of the river so that the water will be behind us, and then build a pond from it so that we will be able to drink if we are thirsty, but they will not be able to drink. So the Prophet ﷺ chose the opinion of this companion, yeah, and they crossed the river and kept it behind them to the direct direction of Medina. And so here it just shows you, subhanAllah, the humility of the Prophet ﷺ, and also it's a refutation of the extreme Sufis who said the Prophet ﷺ knew the knowledge of the unseen. No, he didn't. He was only given what Allah gave him. Yeah, and the Prophet ﷺ mentioned that many times himself. So here, the Prophet ﷺ didn't know, and the companion had a better, advice. And from the humility of the Prophet ﷺ as well, he accepted his advice. فَنَزَلَ بِالْعَدُوَّةِ الدُّنْيَا مِمَّا يَلِي الْمَدِينَةِ وَقُرَيْشٌ بالعدوة القصوى مما يلي مكة، وأنزل الله تلك الليلة مطرا كان على مشركين وابلا شديدا ووحلا زلقا يمنعهم من التقدم، وكان على المسلمين طلا تحرهم ووتعا لهم الأرض، وشد الرمل رملة ومحد المنزل وثبت الأقدام. وبنى المسلمون رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم عريشا على تل مشرف على ميدان حب، ثم نزل صلى الله عليه وسلم من العريش فسوى صفوف أصحابه ومشى في موضع المعركة، وجعل يشير بيده إلى مصارع المشركين ومحلات قتلهم، يقول: هذا مصرع فلان إن شاء الله، هذا مصرع فلان، فما جاوز أحد منهم موضع إشارته. You stop there. So when the Prophet ﷺ obviously followed the advice of the companion Hubab, and they kept the riverbank, the back of the riverbank to the direction of to the direction of Medina, and the Quraysh settled in there further away on the riverbank to the direction of Mecca. Then Allah sent down heavy rain, making it really difficult for the disbelievers. And then it became like mud, and it was hard for them to walk through that, and they became exhausted, and it would become slippy for them, so it prevented them from to proceed. And then upon the Muslims, it was like a drizzle that it purified them and cleansed them and made the ground firm and stable for them and established their feet for them for the battle. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it was a tent was set up for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and then on upon a hill on the battlefield. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam descended from his tent, and then he straightened the ranks of the Muslims, so of the companions. He set them up for battle, and he began walking in the battlefield, and then he began to point with his hand to certain places where he said that the disbelievers would end up dying. So he said, this person will die inshallah in this place. Then he pointed to another place, inshallah this person will die in another place. And then whatever he pointed, and whichever place he pointed to that particular person or from the disbelievers, that's where they died. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he looked into to his companions, and he into the to the Quraysh. ثم نظر إلى سأسمي إذا أصحابي وإلى قريش فقال اللهم هذه قريش جاءت بفخرها وخيلائها وخيلها تحادك وتكذب رسولك اللهم نصرك الذي وعدتني اللهم أنجز لي ما وعدتني اللهم إني أنشدك عهدك ووعدك اللهم إن شئت لم تعبد اللهم إن تحلك هذه الإصابة اليوم لا تعبد. So then the Prophet he made dua, and he said, "Oh Allah, here is Quraysh. They come with their pride and arrogance, and their archers are here opposing you and rejecting your messenger. Oh Allah, we are asking you for victory, which you have promised me. Oh Allah, execute that which you have promised me with. Oh Allah, if you will, you will not be worshipped. Oh Allah, if this group of Muslims are destroyed today, you will not be worshipped." So this is the dua the Prophet made. واستنصر المسلمون ربهم واستغاثوا فاستجاب لهم. So the Muslims, they sought the aid of the Allah. They made dua for his aid and help, and Allah answered them. So here then we go on to the ayah. So let me just get the ayah. So then it's Allah mentions, إِذَا يُوحِي رَبُّكَ إِلَى الْمَلَائِكَةِ أَنِّي مَعَكُمْ فَثَبِّتُوا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا سَأُلْقِي فِي قُلُوبِ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا الرُّعْبَ فَاضْرِبُوا فَوْقَ الْأَعْنَاقِ وَاضْرِبُوا مِنْهُمْ كُلَّ بَنَانٍ ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّهُمْ شَاقُّوا اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ شَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ ذلكم فذوقوه وأن للكافرين عذاب النار. So that's Surah Al-Anfal, verse 12 to 14. So we need to read that. And remember, when your Lord revealed to the angels, "Verily, I am with you. So keep firm those who have believed. I will cast terror into the hearts of those who have disbelieved. So strike them over the necks and smite over all their fingers and toes. This is because they defied and disobeyed Allah and His Messenger. And whoever defies and disobeys Allah and His Messenger, then verily Allah is severe in punishment. This is the torment, so taste it, and surely for the disbelievers is the torment of the fire." So then the Sheikh carries on to the next paragraph. And then he mentioned, ثم تقابل الجمعان وحمي الوطيس واستدارت راح الحرب ورسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في الأريش ومعه أبو بكر وسعد بن معاذ يحرسانه كما زال صلى الله عليه وسلم يناشد ربه ويستنصره ويستغيثه فأغفى إغفاتا ثم خرج. يقول سيحزم الجمع ويولون الدبر. وحرد أصحابه على القتال وقال والذي نفس محمد بيده لا يقاتلهم اليوم رجل فيقتل صابرا محتسبا مقبلا غير مدبرا إلا أدخله الله الجنة. So we just read up to that. And then he, no, we carry on. فقام أمير بن همام الأنصاري وبيده تمرات يأكلهن فقال يا رسول الله جنة أرضها السماوات والأرض. قال النبي نعم. قال بخل بخل يا رسول الله ما بيني وبين أن أدخل الجنة إلا أن يقتلني هؤلاء لئن حييت حتى أكل تمراتي هذه إنها لحياة طويلة. ثم ألقى تمراتي وقاتل حتى قتل رضي الله عنه. This is amazing, mashallah. So here, the Sheikh mentions that the two groups, they met and they clashed and the battle began to heat up. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was in the tent with Abu Bakr and Sa'd bin Mu'ad, who were guarding him while the battle began to intensify. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam continued to make dua to Allah for the help and victory, which Allah promised him. And then he slept, and then when he woke up and he walked out, he said to the people, the enemies will be defeated and they will turn their backs and run away, as mentioned in Surah Al-Qamar. So he then encouraged the companions to fight, saying, I swear by him in whose hand is the soul of Muhammad. Whoever got killed by the disbelievers today, while sincerely fighting them, attacking and defending without running away from the battlefield, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant him paradise. So upon this, subhanAllah, listen to this. Umair, one of the companions, bin Hammam, he said, he wanted to do this. He had a desire to do this. Then he said, O Messenger of Allah, between me and paradise is only if I am killed by these people. The Prophet said, yes. He said, what's it now? Let's see. So yeah, he said, yes. So, then basically he said that, you know, the width of the heavens is, he mentioned here, let's see, he said, yeah, but if between me and paradise is only if I'm killed by these people, then he threw away the dates then that he had in his hands. And then he said, it will be a waste of time for me to finish eating these dates. Then he fought the people. He fought the disbelievers until he was martyred. Subhanallah. Look at that. So yeah, here he's saying that the heaven, the distance is of the heavens and the earth. The Prophet said, yeah, yes. So look at that, how he was told and he believed in what the Prophet said, and he had true belief and he fought until he died. Subhanallah. So then the Shaykh mentions, وَأَخَذَ رَسُولَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ كَفًا مِنْ تُرَابٍ أَوْ حَسًا فرمى بها القوم فأصابت أعينهم فما منهم واحد إلا ملأت عينه وشغلوا بالتراب في أي في أعينهم آية من آيات الله عز وجل، فهزم جمع المشركين وولوا الأدبار، واتبعهم المسلمون يقتلون ويأسرون. قتلوا 70 رجلا وأسروا 70. أما القتل بألقي منهم 24 رجلا من صناديدهم في قليب من قلبان بدر، منهم أبو جهل وشيبة بن ربيعة وأخوه أتبع وابنه الوليد بن أتبع. وفي صحيح البخاري عن عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم استقبل الكعبة فداء على هؤلاء الأربعة، قال: فاشهدوا بالله لقد رأيتهم صرعى قد غيرتهم الشمس، وكان يوم حار. So here the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم got hold of some a handful of sand or dirt in his hand, and he threw it at the enemies, and he filled all their eyes so they could not see and were defeated as a result of that. That is from the mercy of Allah, from the miracles of Allah. So the disbelievers were defeated and they turned their backs and ran away. So the Muslims followed them, killing some of them and capturing others. They killed 70 people from the polytheists and captured 70. Yeah. So they killed 70 of them and they captured 70. So there were 27 leaders of Quraysh who were killed. That was a big thing, you know. This 27 of the leaders were from this from the 70 and were thrown in a ditch. So then their bodies were thrown in a ditch. Some of those leaders who were killed included Abu Jahl, Shayba bin Rabia, his brother Utba, and his son Walid bin Utba. So it's also mentioned in Bukhari that Ibn Masud mentioned that the Prophet ﷺ turned to the direction of the Kaaba and he made dua to Allah against these four people whose name were mentioned above. And Abdullah bin Masud said, I swear by Allah that I saw all of them dead. Their nature was hot by the sun's heat, and that was a very hot day. So Allah's messenger made dua against them that were killed, and they ended up getting killed. وفيه أيضا أن أبي طلحة رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أمر يوم بدر ب24 رجل من صناديد قريش وقذفوا في طوي من أطواء بدر خبيث مخبث، وكان إذا ظهر على قوم أقام بالأرصة 3 ليال. فلما كان ببدر اليوم الثالثة أما براحلته فشد عليه ثم مشى واتبعه أصحابه حتى قام على شفة الرقي، فجعل يناديهم بأسمائهم وأسماء آبائهم: يا فلان ابن فلان، ويا فلان يا فلان ابن فلان، أيسركم أنكم أتأتم الله ورسوله؟ فإنا قد وجدنا ما وعدنا ربنا حقا، فهل وجدتم ما وعدكم ربكم حقا؟ قال عمر: يا رسول الله، ما تكلم من أجساد لا أرواح لها؟ قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: والذي نفس محمد بيده، ما أنتم بأسمع لما أقول منهم. وأما على أسرى فإن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم استشار الصحابة فيهم، وكان سعد بن معاذ قد ساءه أمرهم، وقال: كانت أول وقعة أو أوقعها الله في المشركين، وكان الإثخان في الحرب أحب إلي من استبقاء الرجال. وقال عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: أرى أن تمكننا فنضرب أعناقهم، فتمكن علي من أقيل فيضرب عنقه، فتمكن علي من أقيل فيضرب عنقه، وتمكنني من فلان يعني قريب له فضرب عنقه. فإن هؤلاء أئمة الكفر وسناديدها. وقال أبو بكر رضي الله عنه: هم بنو الأم والعشيرة، وأرى أن تأخذ منهم فدية فتكون لنا قوة على الكفار، فعسى الله أن يهديهم للإسلام. فأخذ النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الفدية، فكان أكثرهم يفتدي بالمال من 4000 درهم إلى 1000 درهم، ومنهم من افتدى بتعليم صبيان أهل المدينة الكتاب والقراءة، ومنهم من كان فداؤه إطلاق معصور عند قريش من المسلمين، ومنهم من قتله النبي صبرا لشدة أذيته، ومنهم من من عليه بدون فداء للمصلحة. طيب، so here we got that he mentioned that also narrated in Sahih Bukhari by Abu Talha on the day of Badr that the Prophet ﷺ ordered the corpses of 24 leaders of Quraysh that they should be thrown in into the one of the dirty wells of Badr. And it was a habit of the Prophet ﷺ that whenever he conquered some people, he used to stay at a battlefield for 3 nights. So on the third day of the battle of Badr, he ordered that his she-camel be saddled so that he could prepare to leave. Then he set out and his companions followed him, saying among themselves, definitely he, the Prophet ﷺ, is proceeding for some great purpose. So they followed him. When he halted at the edge of the well, he addressed the dead bodies of the Quraysh and the infidels by their names and their father's names. He said, oh, so-and-so, son of so-and-so, oh, so-and-so, son of so-and-so, would it have pleased you if you had obeyed Allah and His Messenger? We have found true what our Lord has promised us. Have you too found true what your Lord has promised you? So Umar bin Khattab, may Allah be pleased, him said, oh Allah's Messenger, you are speaking to bodies that have no soul. Allah's Messenger said, by him in whose hand is Muhammad's soul, you do not hear what I say better than they do. So Qatada, one of the scholars mentioned, Allah brought them to life again to let them hear him in order to be reprimanded, slight them, take revenge over them, and cause them to feel remorse and regret. And that's mentioned in Sahih Bukhari. So the Prophet ﷺ asked the companions regarding what they should do with the war captives. So Sa'd bin Mu'adh said he disliked that the Quraysh did, and this is not the first battle that enemies were defeated, and I'd rather have them killed than to keep them alive. So he was saying Sa'd bin Mu'adh wanted them to be killed. While Umar bin Khattab said, I think you should allow us to strike their necks. So here, I made a mistake, said Ali. So that Allah, he said, let them strike their necks. I think you should allow us to strike their necks. And let Ali strike the neck of Aqil, because he was in relation to him. And let me strike the neck of so-and-so, who was a relation of his. For verily, these people are the leaders of disbelief. But then Abu Bakr, he mentioned here that I think you should allow us to strike their necks. So Abu Bakr said, these men are our cousins and our countrymen. I see it more appropriate that the Muslims should take ransom from them and exchange them for wealth. And this will be strength for the Muslims over the disbelievers. And perhaps Allah will guide them to Al-Islam. So the Prophet ﷺ, he chose the opinion of Abu Bakr. And he accepted to take the wealth in exchange for the war captives, for some of them, and most of them were paid for 4,000 dirhams, and some of them with 1,000 dirhams, and some of them were told that they would be freed if they taught the children of the Muslims in Medina how to read and write. And some of them were exchanged with the Muslim captives that the Kufar had of the Muslims that were in the hands of the Quraysh. And some of them were killed by the Prophet ﷺ due to the, you know, the severity of the harm that they caused the Muslims. And some of them were released without any money being exchanged, but for the interest of the Muslims. So then the Sheikh, he finally stops. He says, "هذه غزوة بدر انتصرت فيها فئة قليلة قليلة على فئة كثيرة." So he said, "This is this battle of Badr is a group, a small group, was victorious over a large group." So they mentioned the Quran, "فئة تقاتل في سبيل الله وأخرى كافرة." Surah Al-Imran, verse 13. A group fighting for the sake of Allah, whereas the others were disbelievers. So, intasarat al-fi'atu al-qalila li'annaha qa'imatun bi-deenillah tuqatilu li'i'la'i kalimatihi wa difa'an deenihi. Fanasaraha Allahu azza wa jal. Faqoomu bi-deenikum ayyuhal muslimun li'tunsiru ala a'da'ikum wa wasbiru wa sabiru. So here the Sheikh, he mentions that how the small group was victorious only because they were supporting the religion of Allah. They were fighting to make the word of Allah victorious and defend his religion. Therefore, establish your religion, O Muslims, so that you will be help against your enemies. Be patient and stand up firm upon your religion and fear Allah, so that you will be successful. Then the Sheikh ends with a dua, Allahumma ansurna bil Islam waj'alna min ansarihi wa du'ati ilayhi wa thabbitana alayhi ila an nalqaka wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. So he said, "Oh Allah, help us with al-Islam, make us among those who support Islam, and keep us firm upon it till we meet you. May the peace and blessings of Allah be upon the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad, and his family and his companions, all of them." And we finish with that. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu alayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.